bad seed returns. Or is it the prodigal daughter? Well, don't just stand there, come in. After all, you have only 9 minutes to save the world.
You're really him.
First things first, I'm gonna need you to place your weapons on the floor.
Why would I want to do that?
This is what you're after, yes? The antivirus, the cure to all this. Well, there's only one vial. We're a half a mile underground in a sealed facility. I drop it here. The antivirus goes nowhere, and your hopeless dreams will die sooner rather than later. Good girl.
You're still armed.
Yes, I am.
Claire would be so disappointed.
A few minutes, Claire would be dead. Along with everybody else, you know.
That's sweet.
Sorry. My love. Move away from the weapon. I'm the detonator. If you place explosives in high command cryo tubes, I'll disarm them.
Thank you. You've done well. Doc. The ice pick, the decanter, or the fountain pen. And in answer to your question, yes. Apart from a few technological upgrades, I'm Dr. Alexander Roland Isaacs, the original.
When I met out there, he taught exactly the same thing.
And of course he did. That's how they're designed. They always try harder and fight longer, even to the death, as long as they think they're the real thing. After all, who wants to know they're just a poor imitation of a worthless copy? Which brings us to you.
No.
Oh, come now. You thought you were the original. How delicious. No, I'm afraid she holds that dubious honor. Alicia Marcus, daughter of my old partner James, co-owner of the Umbrella Corporation and a painful thorn in my side. One I now intend to remove.
Time is running out, Alice. You must kill him soon.
It's good to see you too, Alicia. Marcus created the T-virus to save her, but the effects didn't last. I've been waiting years for her to die.
I'm not a clone.
Really? You must have wondered why you remember nothing of your childhood. Your father. Your mother.
Memory loss.
No. You have no memory because you had no life. Nothing before the mansion when we created you 10 years ago.
I know who I am.
I don't think so. You're nothing more than a puppet whose strings were cut. And then you wandered around for a little while, thinking you were a real girl, but you're not. You're just a clever imitation. A facsimile. A rather troublesome one at that.
You're lying to me.
I'm afraid he's not. You were created in her image, as was I. My likeness and voice were based on childhood recordings of Lisa Marcus, made by her father. Your genetic structure is based on her DNA, tweaked to avoid the progeria aging disease that afflicted her. I'm the child she was. You are the woman she would have been.
Oh, you are so much better than I ever could. I let this happen. I was weak. You cannot afford to be.
Time is running out, Alice.
No touching. The trinity of bitches, united in their hatred. Not that it'll do you any good. I've been ahead of you every step of the way. You've changed nothing. You've saved no one. The world will still be cleansed and the Umbrella Corporation will triumph. The only difference is I'll no longer have to listen to your self-righteous whining. When you uploaded that file to the Red Queen's data stream, you turned against the corporation. When the rest of the board awake, you'll be replaced. And I will assume complete control.
I still own 50% of this company.
And what you intend to do with that?
You are co-owner of this corporation. But Wesker is still an employee.
I don't have to take your orders. My loyalties are with him.
I know. Albert Wesker, you're fired. Few minutes, and the last remaining human outposts will fall.
We need an intercept path and the fastest way to the surface.
Already done.
If you release the antivirus, it will kill all organisms infected with the T-virus. You know what that means, don't you? For you.
I know. Alice, you can't. I don't have a choice. There has to be another way.
No, there isn't.
4 minutes and 33 seconds left. You have to hurry.
Scott.